Father God, I am just learning how to pray. Bear with me. First, I thank you for the life of everyone that's here with me. Then I thank you for the love you give me. Why? I don't know. I don't deserve it, and it hurts inside. Many a nights I cried and called your name out loud, but didn't call you when I was doing good, too proud. And still you gave me love. I wasn't used to that. Most of the people that gave me love ended up taking it back. That's something new to me. So I'm asking you for time to adjust. Let me make it there. I will be one you can trust. What I stand for, I put my life on. I do. I guess what I'm asking is, show me how to stand for you. And I will rap for you, sing for you, reach for you, preach for you, teach for you. I will love you like you love me, unconditionally. And I will always be prepared for whatever the mission will be. Give the nutrition to me, and I'll properly digest it. And when I give it back, I will show you word well invested. And whenever I go, before I go, let me give. Thanks to you, Lord, for my birth, for every day that I've lived. You gave me a love most of my life I didn't know was there. I give you my life, because you cared. Amen.
Amen.
But you know what? Fuck them. The game is bullshit, man. The game is fucking bullshit. If you want to rap or sing or whatever, don't become a part of the game.
Don't become a part of the game.
You know what? Listen to a song I got called The Industry. And that pretty much explains, you know, saying what the shit is about. The industry. Man, it's not the same. The industry. It's not a fucking game. The industry. Real niggas is dying to get in the industry just to find they don't fit in. The industry ain't what it used to be. The industry's trying to control the way you MC. They want you to dress like this and talk like that. But I'm going to dress like this and talk with the gat. The industry. Got y'all word meaning nothing. The industry. Fuck what you heard because he's bluffing. The industry. Money, bitches, hate. But I dare you to try to take a fucking thing off my plate. The industry like, wait. But in the streets, we like, get him. 17 up in that thing, catch him sleeping, and hit him. My pop whoever's with him. The coroner's coming to get him. Industry niggas, so that's why I did him. I mean,
the most realest dog in the whole game, the guy who reinvented the game, the guy who put it on there, man. I mean, you came out at a time when it was all shiny suits,
yeah.
It was all like, man, sparkly shoes.
I gave them their best year ever.
Exactly.
And I'm the only artist to date with 2 platinum albums in 1 year.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Understand.
And what
that.
Did they do? They sold the company. They invited me into a house and they sold it. Yeah, I am mad. You know what I mean? Go right, I'm mad. I feel betrayed, man, but it. You know what I mean? It's a business and I'm gonna carry it like a business. But my music is still my fucking music. And you play on my music, you play on my life. You play on my life, nigga, you're gonna disappear. You know what I mean?
Yeah, things are definitely changing there, man.
Yeah, they got a whole new staff now, so I gotta go in and see what's up. You know what I'm saying?
Now, you got issues with the industry. What's going down with the industry, dog?
The industry is full of a bunch of dick-sucking, dick-riding, bending-over-the-desk-ass niggas, straight up like that. Whoever don't like it, bring it, nigga. Bring it. I don't give a fuck. Bring it. Bring it. Bitch. Bitch.
They got this new breed of rapper that's paying DJs to play their shit.
Right.
And, you know what I'm saying? They sucking the record label executive dicks and it's like,
you know what I'm saying? They sucking the record label executive dicks and it's like,
there's too much of that going on.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Let me be me. Let me be the artist that I am and just play my motherfucking music. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Now they want you all up under this, you know, sitting going to dinner with them and shit like that. And, you know, all that favor for a favor shit. I don't get down like that. Look, I'll give you the music. You give me my money. That's it.
Oh. Looked like 15. You know what I mean? So we had to send.
R. Kelly, what's up?
We had to send a Def Jam rep. yeah, R. Kelly, what's up, brother? We got minors in the building.
Yeah, R. Kelly, what's up, brother? We got minors in the building.
You fucking bitch ass nigga. When I see you, I'm gonna spit in your fucking face. Bang. Fuck.
R. Kelly.
Fuck that nigga. Fuck that nigga with an elephant dick, you fucking bitch.
Wow.
Rough Rider G-Unit Radio.
Yes, this is what we doing,
man. This is how we like it.
Kato, yo, you know what I'm saying? And me, yo. Yo, nigga, invited me to the studio.
Wow.
Now, we show up at a video shoot for him. You know what I'm saying? Now, Kato, nigga, Kato was pressing me to do a song for a minute.
Wow.
Like, oh, I'm going to do it. Leave him alone. Nigga, Kato kept the nigga safe in Chicago. That nigga's pussy.
Wow.
Now, so, I show up at the studio on his behalf to do a song for him. So, I tell nigga, now, he wasn't even at the studio, but I'm still there because I'm a professional.
Shit.
So, I said, all right, I'm going to bang. Lee, what up? All right? I'm going to bang my shit out. You know what I'm saying? So, I say, yo, you know what? Let me take the beat. You know what I'm saying? Back to the hotel and watch you when I come back home. So, and his manager's like 50 years old. His uncle and his manager.
Wow.
And I said, yo, ask him if I take the beat. This nigga is in a room in the studio.
Nah.
He ain't got enough respect to come to the room I'm in. You mean? You in a
room? Oh, he's in
room?
A separate room. He got two.
He's in a room downstairs.
Come on,
somebody
man.
To talk to you.
Come on, man.
Uncle with his manager. I ain't got a problem with that.
Come
but
on.
The way he talked to the nigga was crazy. Like this. He talking through the fucking lock.
Yo.
Nah.
You're out. That's supposed to know he can take the beat.
Come
nigga,
on,
right back
man.
To the lock.
No.
Oh. I'm sitting right there like,
oh,
yeah, that's what's up?
That's that wax shit.
I said, why I can't think of, let me see you talking about, because, you know, beats, it's a fucking beat.
That's wax,
it's a
yo.
Beat. You ain't your vocals in on there. Can't nobody put that on a mixtape. And hold up, who the fuck you think I am anyway, nigga? Like,
wow.
I'm not thirsty to leak a fucking song with you.
Come on,
I don't
man.
Even fuck with you like that. Yo.
Thank you for doing this, by the way.
Thank you for, you know, giving me the opportunity to be heard, you know, in a positive light.
Yeah.
Or just in a fair light.
And if I inadvertently talk about your situation, mm-hmm.
I got you.
You let me know.
I got you. Okay. All right, I first came to Arizona, man, and I remember one day coming from the studio at 6 o'clock in the morning and pulling over on the highway. We like 4 cars, you know, just to watch the sunrise. And it was at that point that I fell in love with Arizona. I said, you know what, this has to be God's country. You know, because I'd never seen anything as beautiful as that sunrise. Then I met the devil in God's country. You
who's
know,
that?
And it's not so much who, it's what, you know, what happens and the things that the devil does. It's not so much a person, even though he acts through people. You know, you can't call one person the devil.
Joe Arpaio?
You know, you can't call any one person the devil. You can't do that because no one person has enough power to be the devil. You know? And, you know, it's through all these hardships that I realized that, you know what? This is God's country because I met the devil here. Because if I hadn't met the devil here, I wouldn't realize I was strong enough to overcome the obstacles that the devil would place in my path. And it's by overcoming these obstacles that I realized that this is God's country. Because he helped me get over these obstacles. He helped me get over these hurdles.
Okay, so but when you're done here, when
yeah.
you're out of here,
I'm not looking back.
You're not coming back.
No, I'm not coming back. I'm not coming back for a show. I'm not coming back for a visit. I'm not even driving through the states. If I'm in a plane and they're gonna fly over it, I'm gonna go around. Okay.
But you love this place.
Ah, I love the scenery. I love the scenery about it, and I love the freedom that it initially gave a person. Remember, I said when I first came here. The last exit on the 101 was Pima and Princess. Yeah, that was the last exit, you know? And, you know, man, we had fun. We had the four-wheelers, you know. We just rode the trails. Pretty much the same thing I did when I bought a house out here, but until, you know, things, yeah, I don't know.
Do you, when you think back on this whole thing,
yeah.
what went wrong in Arizona? What... How did you end up getting in so much trouble here? Was there too much temptation here, or were
I actually didn't get in,
was after you?
No, I didn't get in. I actually didn't get in any trouble. I was never arrested at the scene of any crime, or you know, the police came and arrested me for something. You know, it was always let's get an arrest warrant for this guy. You know,
you think?
It was always let's get an arrest warrant for this guy. You know.
Last is a probation matter involving possession of marijuana, which is also a class 6 felony.
See the fair treatment going on. Only one in here. Look
the only one who got arrested today. Do it every time, man. Every time, man. Every time they do it to me. They gotta be quiet about it. I get my rights violated, but I gotta be quiet about it. Let's go.
Come on. Let's go.
Now, let's go. It's a f***ing bitch.
Normal traffic stop. Normal traffic stop. 18 cops, 5 cars.
Shit. This ain't no normal traffic stop.
I'm coming in the house, and I'm gunning for your spouse. Trying to send a back to a maker. And if you got a daughter older than 15, I'm a raper. Take her on the living room floor, right there in front of you. I'ma make you suffer. See your ass in hell, motherfucker. See your ass in hell.
I got blood on my hands, and there's no remorse. I got blood on my cause I fucked your car. I got blood on my hands, and there's no remorse.
Trying to do something.
Yeah, I'm trying to form a union, you know what I'm saying? Because there's no one who protects the artists, the rights of the artists, and we continue to get jerked, you know what I'm saying? We pay for our fucking music, but the record company owns it. What type of backwards that shit is? That's like getting a loan from the bank for a house, that's when you're paying back, they still own the house. That shit is not fair, you know what I'm saying? And the percentage that they give you isn't fair, you know what I'm saying? The split is ridiculous. The highest paid rap artist gets maybe 18 to 23 cents off a dollar. What the fuck type of shit is that, man? I'm not a slave, man. And how the fuck you gonna call me a risk and get hold on to me for 7 years? If I'm a risk, it's 1 year at a time. 1 year at a time. That's what you do with a risk. You don't lock a risk in for 7 years, especially when the average expectancy of anybody's career is 3 fucking years. You'd have to be a super incredible nigga to outlive that contract and then get money for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Right. This shit is crazy.
Well, you got supporting you with that? Anybody supporting you on that?
Yeah, I'm not gonna, you know, say any names, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, you know, I talked to a few people about it. Some niggas are scared. I mean, you know.
Nobody wanna step up, huh?
Yeah, but, I mean, you know, it's gonna be done. I wrote that motherfucking rhyme, you know what I'm saying? I put that beat with it, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Come on, man, it's being sold because of me. I mean, if I put some whack shit out there and they still made it sell, then that'd be a whole other story. And they get that percentage, but they don't, you know what I mean?
Is something you want to tell the people to help you support that, man, that they might know?
Well, I'm pretty
this is going straight to the hood right here for the young
guys. Oh, to the hood. Coming up.
To this the is hood. DVD magazine.
Yo,
right
keep
here.
It gravy, man, you know what I'm saying? To the fellas, you know what I'm saying? Be a man about your shit, you know what I'm saying? Don't be no coward ass nigga, you know what I'm saying? To the ladies, respect yourself, love yourself, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate who you are, but know who you are. God bless you all. So every song, I look at it like, okay, this is a single. You know what I'm saying? When I write it, I got a picture, the video and everything, you know? So I'll be trying to make no album, fellas, you know? Something just put on the beat and just blah, blah, blah. You know, 20 years. I've been rapping for 20 years, you know what I'm saying? I don't know at what point I officially became in the industry and, you know? Record label wants to make a successful artist, you know what I'm saying? And they can do it, you know what I'm saying? They buy radio time, they buy time on fucking BET and MTV, you know what I'm saying? I mean, it has nothing to do with talent at all, it's, you know what I'm saying?
This is, they create fucking stars. I pay for every aspect of getting my album, taking my album from my mind to the stores. I pay for it all. I pay for the studio time. I pay for the living expenses, you know what I'm saying? I pay for the packaging, you know what I'm saying? The pressing of the records, the promotion. I pay for all that shit. And they own the masters. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? I'm paying for it, but they own it. The fuck, I'd have to be a fucking idiot to continue to operate under these conditions. It's like, I'm not, they're not, the highest paid artists get like 26 cents off a dollar. They say you shit for $20. You know what I mean? It's like, come on, dog. Right. You can do a little better than that. Yeah. I can't use my own music without getting your permission.
Exactly.
And I paid for it. Not only I wrote it, you know what I'm saying? I paid the nigga for the beat. I paid you for loaning me the money. You know what I'm saying? I paid you back your money. Now we splitting because you loaned me the money.
Yeah.
But you own my shit. I don't owe you a motherfucking thing. Why is you holding on to my shit?
Yeah.
And that's standard. Like, man, get the fuck out of here, man. Suck my fucking dick. You know what I mean? Fuck that. Fuck man. That. Should be having me heated like a motherfucker, man. You know what I'm saying?
While I think about it, I'd
be like, nigga, this is straight fucking rock. You know what these cocksucking motherfuckers had the nerve to fucking offer me? The fucking the video game they did. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. First one did good, so now they're coming out with a part two. They sell a game for $50. These niggas come to me like, yo, guess what, X? We're gonna do a part two. Now, mind you, they use my music throughout the whole fucking game, and I'm the hardest character to get to. You know what I'm saying? So it's pretty much like my shit. You know what I'm saying? They say, they come to me and say, yo, we're gonna give you a $25,000 signing bonus, advance, and 2 cents off every game we sell.
They know what
$50 they're doing. Fucking game. You giving me 2 cents? Let me think about that for a minute.
Is there anything else you'd like to say to the people who are watching this tonight?
Pray for me, because I pray for you. Don't believe everything you hear. Don't believe everything you read. And only believe half of what you see. God bless you.
Going on with y'all, man? It's Black Balloon, and we are back on Sunday, man. Sunday Sacrifice series continues. That was DMX, Dark Man X, Earl Simmons, DMX the legend. Y'all already know what's going on, man. We back. It's Sunday. I hope y'all enjoyed that video. You know, so as far as the entire DMX situation, you know, we were all just basically waiting on, you know, waiting on them to officially announce that he was dead. You know, with the minds that we have around all this kind of stuff, you know, we don't actually know what day he truly died. You know, none of the fans or anybody on the outside looking in was actually there in the hospital, you know, or wherever he was being held at. You know, none of us truly knows. You know, it could have played out exactly how they said. He could have had his overdose on the 3rd, which was a little bit over a week ago, and he just died 2 days ago, Friday. It could have played out that way. Or, you know, he could have, you know, actually been dead, and this was just how they chose to roll it out to us. So we already know how the occult likes to, you know, sacrifice these rappers, these celebrities, you know what I'm saying? Mind you, DMX was 50 years old. You know, we can have a short list of, you know, very high profile musicians that died at 50 years old. So we get DMX at 50. We get Michael Jackson at 50. We get Prince at 50. We get Bernie Mac at 50. We get Luther Vandross at 50. And that's just what I thought of right off the top of my head. I'm sure there's some more. if y'all got more celebrities, doesn't have to be artists or anything. Let me know, you know, who else died at 50 years old. Let me know in the comments, because I know there's more. I didn't even look this up. I just know that off the top of my head. So, you know, that's one thing that's pretty strange, obviously, when we start to add up the so-called coincidences that we all know, you know, don't exist. And then, of course, we get the overdose factor. You know, once again, we get an artist has overdosed, even at 50 years old, even at a time where it seemed like this person, you know, didn't even dwell in that kind of lifestyle anymore. But who knows? You know, we don't know what DMX did in his lifestyle, if he smoked a little weed or whatever the case may be. But we all know the narrative that they like to give us, excuse me, as far as these artists overdosing, because this is what you expect. You expect DMX to die from, you know, some shit that he used to do that was detrimental to himself. You expect that. You know what I'm saying? So that's how they roll out their death. You know what I'm saying? So you know me, I'm not gonna sit here and say DMX is even dead. You know, y'all know we leave that open so we can figure it out, or at least try to. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I can't do any of these videos, and, you know, it's only a certain amount of videos that I've done sacrifice wise that I can say that they're dead, you know. But with this DMX situation, honestly, I don't know. Like, I'm not gonna 100% say that he is dead, but his character has definitely been sacrificed out of this scene, out of the world, you know. So whatever they were working on, whatever album was coming up or was dropped recently, they're gonna, like I said in the video before, they'll rake millions off of his names. His streams have already shot up, you know, I'm pretty sure a couple 100%, who knows. You know what I'm saying? So the people that own his music and rights and publishing, like I said, and like he said, those people that own that shit, you know, they bringing it, they raking in the cash. You know what I'm saying? They coming up right now, you know, because everybody is DMX, DMX, DMX. You know what I'm saying? So we already know how that goes, man, as far as artists, you know, overdosing and just how they roll out the entire thing, you know. And we've already paid attention to the numbers, the fact that he had, he OD'd on 4-3-2-1, you know, April being the fourth month, third day of the month, and the 21st year of the new, you know, whatever we live in, 2021, y'all know what I'm trying to say. But, so yeah, we can't deny that. And of course, y'all already knew he had that song 4-3-2-1 with LL Cool J, Method Man, Red Man, and Cannabis, you know, which I just felt like I'd go back over that talking wise. I don't want to put that in a video because y'all already know, and I already said something in the last video. So that's basically another coincidence that we can't ignore. You know what I'm saying? Another coincidence. Yeah, that we can't ignore, you know. Like I'll always say, I don't believe in coincidences, so it's just up to you on how you feel about him actually being featured on a song that was called 4-3-2-1, and he actually has, you know, an overdose and, you know, organs and heart failure and all that stuff basically on that same day, 4-3-2021. You know, so you take that how you want to take it. If you believe it to just be, you know, this is just a coincidence, then hey, you know, if that makes your day feel better, then so be it. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, to kind of just wrap this all up, not to keep it talking too long, man, doing this video, which I didn't have this plan to do this Sunday. You know, I had a completely different video I was working on, but obviously this jumped the line, because a lot of people just wanted to, you know, wanted the video, and just, y'all already know how we do it, man. But it was dope. It was dope doing this video and going back, you know, watching a lot of the stuff that, you know, I've seen a lot of the stuff before. I think about two interviews I put in the video I didn't see before. So it was dope just going back, just getting the feel of who DMX was again. And hopefully for the ones that just didn't really know much about him, you know, maybe this video has shed some light on who he was as a person and how outspoken he was toward the industry. You know, so it's kind of that typical story. You know, they all get down at first. You know, they all see the money. They see, you know, the fame, blah, 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 and they're blinded, you know, until they start to realize what's actually going on. And you can kind of tell DMX had a spirit the entire time. You know what I'm saying? Regardless of him actually selling his soul, he was very aware of what he was doing, and he put that in his music. You know, he knew he crossed over to that dark side. He knew he gave up his soul, and, you know, he went against his moral code to get what he got. You know, and he just happened to be the ones that it eats him up so much inside that he has to express it. He has to be outspoken about it. And eventually that energy takes over, you know, it takes over. And he just realized that it was some bullshit. The entire industry was bullshit. The people in it are bullshit, fake, you know, just playing the game. You know what I'm saying? Just like he said, it's just a game that they playing. You know what I'm saying? And some motherfuckers get into that shit and they just can't fake the funk. You know what I'm saying? And that's just how it happens. And you end up biting the bullet because you signed an oath to the devil. The devil don't give a damn about you changing your mind. You already done gave me your soul. I don't give a damn about you changing your mind. I'm still going to get what I get at you. And I'm going to end your life. And we're going to end your life when we decide, you know, it's that time. And that's just what it is. You know, the devil comes and collect. Y'all already know that. So, yeah, man. That's pretty much it, man. That's pretty much it. That's all I got on the DMX sacrifice. You know, like I said, hope y'all enjoyed that video. It's Sacrifice Sunday. And y'all already know what's going on, man. So, you know, y'all take care of yourselves. It's Black Balloon. And I'm going to see y'all soon.